Svetlana.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have been communicating for more than 3 months. And finally you meet each other, spend 15 or 13 days together. And I want to know your general impressions about your meeting, about how did you find Svetlana, how Svetlana did find you. So, briefly, in a few words.
Мне так в нескольких словах, пожалуйста, опишите то, как вы встретились. Вы провели уже 13 дней вместе. Какие у вас впечатления, как вы познакомились, как вы находите друг друга? Ну, поделитесь этими впечатлениями с нами, пожалуйста. Или с Светланой.
Let's start.
Начнем с девушек. No, guys first.
Oh, really? Well, I found Svetlana in the Surprise Hotel waiting for me.
Okay, and you're serious?
No, no. In all honesty, I couldn't believe how lucky I was that she turned up. And she came back every day. I still can't believe she's here. It's just
mind-blowing.
And she looks at my face and cracks up. I must have a funny face.
No, don't worry, you have a happy face.
Ah, funny. Yeah, okay.
And what about Svetlana?
Ну, я искала мужчину веселого, энергичного, чтоб поддерживал меня во всем. В принципе, Кэрри подходит мне.
Well, actually, I was looking for a man who would be supportive, happy, and who would actually always be by my side, and frankly speaking, I find all these qualities in Kelly. So we will see what will happen next.
I noticed you said quantities, not qualities, but anyway.
Qualities.
I have plenty of quantities.
And what about Ukraine and other Ukrainian girls? Did you find them attractive?
That's a loaded question, isn't it?
Yes.
I think Ukraine's a very beautiful country. I think it has such great potential. I think more people should come and visit, except these tourists. Yes, there are a lot of beautiful women here, but I really haven't been paying any attention. Apart from Oksana, who just happened to work in the hotel. But that's fine, but that's a little joke, isn't it?
And did you plan, have you already planned your another meeting? Maybe here?
What, with Oksana?
No, with Svetlana.
Well, I haven't asked her yet, but we're thinking, asked her, whatever, maybe an Asian country, because apparently if you're Ukrainian, you can get there without visas, which makes life easier, and I'll be back in December.
Okay, thank you guys, thank you very much for this short interview. We wish you all the best. And we know that you're leaving today. Kelly, we will miss you.
And yeah. See you soon. Again.
Yes. And see you soon again. Bye.
Bye.
Hello, Kelly.
Hello.
Would you mind to answer a few questions?
Certainly.
All right. I would like to know. And basically, everyone would like to know why did you decide to find a girl using an internet service, internet site, basically?
Well, it's fairly simple. I couldn't find anybody in Australia, and I'm very busy. And I thought that internet dating, international dating, would be an easier or a better option where you can meet people directly.
Okay, and why did you decide to use this particular site, or have other sites where you can fight at guilds?
Well, I think it was the approach that Ukraine Grows agency site has. It seemed to me that they're very concerned for the welfare of the ladies and also for the welfare of the clients, and I think that's important. And the availability of being able to speak directly to the website owner, Kevin Gordon, if you have any concerns, was also to ensure that you are protected in all sorts of various ways.
And why did you decide to find a guild from Ukraine?
Well, I think they're very beautiful. I think they have high moral values, they're very hardworking, and it just naturally progressed to Ukraine. I just basically went looking for somebody and fell over Ukraine Bride's website, and here I am.
Okay, and a few words about the site. Does it easy to use for the site?
It's very easy to use. It's completely upfront from the very beginning. You can know the ladies for free. You can read their profiles for free. When you first join, you get 3 credits to if you want to send a letter. In comparison with other sites, their services are far cheaper than letter translations, online chatting and video chatting are far better. It's a professional site, it's easy to use, and you know exactly what you're paying for and how much it will cost before you have to pay for anything.
Mm-hmm. And before Svetlana, did you communicate with other girls?
Yes, I did for a small period of time. And they're all very pleasant to talk to. But in regards to Svetlana, I saw her photograph the first day I joined. And I said to myself, you're wasting your time talking to Svetlana, and I didn't have a chance. And after a couple of weeks, I was drawn to her beauty and also to her profile, very much so. And after a couple of weeks, I sent a nudge and a letter, and that's where our conversation started.
Okay, and basically what has attracted you most in Svetlana?
Her soul, her kindness, her generosity, her hard-working philosophy, her diligence, her commitment to the sun, her refusal there to accept presents all the time. I keep offering to send them in, and when she knew I was coming, she kept refusing to accept gifts because it was more important for her, for me to come to visit, as opposed to just constantly receive gifts all the time.
And how long have you been communicating so far?
Since the 16th of March 2014, this year.
Yes. Nearly more than 3 months.
Three and a half months, yes. Mm.
And what did Svetlana find you?
I still have no idea. To be perfectly frank, I have absolutely no idea what she sees in me at all.
And did you talk about this?
No, I was just happy that she did. I didn't want to press the issue. I think what I've noticed in some of the things that you and I have done together, and in going to shopping from anywhere from groceries to engagement rings, that the people in Ukraine are very, very service orientated, extraordinarily friendly, have a wonderful sense of humour, and if anybody sees this video, the best thing you can do is come. Find your girl on the site and come and visit. And if you're a half decent sort of a person, has a sense of humour, you won't go wrong.
But yes, back to Svetlana. So when you first time met Svetlana here in Zaporozhye. And was she the same as you have expected to see her?
As in the physical appearance?
Physical, moral, just...
Oh, far, far better, far better. Her pictures, both the professional ones that are on the website and also the ones that she sent me, the personal pictures that she takes on her phone, are nothing in comparison to the person that I've met here. And I am blown away, completely shocked by how much more there is to Svetlana in real than what possibly can come through in chat or video chat or letters. I'm a very, very lucky man.
And did you often chat with Svetlana?
Yes, we chatted every day. Mm-hmm. I don't want to get in trouble when she's at work. She would have a couple of hours each day because the ladies here work very, very hard, and Svetlana works a lot of hours, and we would text chat here, and we would try to arrange a video chat when it's convenient for her to come to the agency. And I think we've had three video chats, and the only one that one of them didn't work because of my internet connections. So it was good in that way, but yeah, we try to chat every day, and that is very important, even if it's just for 5 minutes to say hello. But the text chat are what I recommend initially, because it's just you and your girl, or in my case, Svetlana, without the interpreter, which can be a little bit off-putting initially, until you get used to your interpreter.
Did Svetlana introduce you to her family?
Yes, I've met her mum. Mm-hmm. I still haven't met the father, but I'm sure that will happen in time when she feels comfortable. And with her mother, Galina, came for us with a couple of trips. We went out on a boat on the river, and we've been out for, I think, a couple of meals together. And it's been very, very good, and I think it's important to ensure that you have a rapport with the mum, also than the father, because you are, after all, a foreign man who has come here with intentions of marriage for her daughter. So she needs to know what sort of a man you are in a very small and short space of time, simply because of the tyranny of distance.
So she didn't afraid to introduce you to her family?
No.
I know that the father has a son. Did you communicate with her son so far?
Oh yes, Renard. He's a wonderful, he's five, and sometimes I feel a little bit guilty because when Renard comes on our dates, as we can call them that, I often spend more time playing with Renard than what I do talking to Svetlana or Galina. He's a wonderful boy. I love him very much, and I'd be honoured to be his dad. And I actually enjoy playing with Renard very much. He is a blessing to his mother, and a great tribute to the way in which she's been raised.
And your trip is nearly finished. You will leave Ukraine just with Ace. And what about your future communication with clients? And where did you stop for the moment?
Well, at the moment we're talking obviously while we're here. When I returned back to Australia, I brought a computer over, a brand new laptop that I bought before I left, one so I can run my business while I'm here, but it will stay here with Svetlana, because guys, if you're watching this, it's very important to know that the girls work very hard, but their income is not particularly high. So please, if you want to talk to them, think about their financial situation. They're not in it for the money, don't misunderstand, but they do need help if you can do it. So I brought a computer over so that we can talk on Skype. Two reasons. It gets her away from translators and agencies and all the intermediaries, not that there's anything wrong with agencies, but that's what it will do. But it will give us a chance to talk one-on-one. And so that's how we'll talk. And I hope to come back in another 6 to 8 weeks, probably not Ukraine, but maybe a place where ladies from Ukraine can go, such as Bali or Singapore, Jamaica, something like that. Then we'll both meet there, and we'll bring her mum and her son with us as well. And that way, Galina can look after Renat when Svetlana and I are off. And that will give us some time to have learned some English. And of course, I'm also learning Russian at the same time, because it's unfair to expect one person to learn the language if you're not prepared to have a crack at Russian as well.
Maybe just a few words about the service you've been provided here by the agency. I mean, interpreter, all the entertainment.
Oh, okay. Well, Svetlana was with Jasmine Models. She's an agency here in Zaporozhye, and Karina runs it. And I cannot speak highly enough of both Karina and Jasmine Models. Very, very professional and very, very helpful. And of course, my main man, Stas, over here, has been my interpreter for the last week and a bit, I suppose.
More than
a week, yes. And we spent the second day I was here, because Svetlana was at work, and we just spent the day, a couple of hours together, talking, chatting, getting to know each other. If you get that opportunity, guys, spend the day with your translator or interpreter, because you need to be able to build a rapport with him or her, so that you can, he can sort of understand you better, what you're trying to say to Svetlana, because some things just don't translate, but the meaning always does. And everything's been arranged for me. I haven't had to do absolutely anything. I get picked up from the motel, we spend the day, I get dropped back at the motel, and it's been fantastic. Stas and his wife, they've come to the motel, we've had dinner together. So not only have I found my future wife and son here, but I've also developed a very close friendship with Stas and his wife, who just happens to be called Svetlana as well. And I'm sure that friendship will continue into the long-term future.
Okay, and so how do you rate the hospitality here?
Oh, it's absolutely fantastic in Zaporozhye. I can't speak for the rest of Ukraine, I've only been to Zaporozhye, but from what and even in that other city you went to, though I'm not even going to pronounce, starts with a D. Perhaps you might like to pronounce that city. That place. Don't try it, gentlemen, it's too hard. It's the hospitality, the people are very warm and friendly. As you probably see in the news, as from here now, there's all this supposed trouble in Ukraine. I have never felt any way frightened, scared, or anything. I feel completely safe and comfortable here in Ukraine. If you're really looking for a wife and you're really serious, use Ukraine Brides Agency. Come see, and you will not go home disappointed.
Okay, and yeah, the last question is just, what would you advise to the people who are going to finding a lady via into the dating? Just a few words.
Yeah, very simple. Find a good website. If you're on Ukraine Brides Agency, take it from me. I have nothing to gain by telling you this. You will not be disappointed. They are an honest website. I'm not getting paid for this interview at all. So there's no benefit for me to say anything to you. Go to Ukraine Brides Agency, you'll have a great time. Talk to the girls. Best thing you can do is talk to the girls that you like to talk to, get to know them, and then after a couple of weeks, pick one and concentrate on one. Get to know that person. Don't wait too long for a visit. I waited just on 3 months before I literally came from Australia. It's a 40-hour flight. So pick one girl, talk to her for 3 months, get a rapport going on. Once you've done that, come over and see your girl everything will be just fine.
Okay, and the last question. So, what will be your next step in relationships with Svetlana?
Well, yep, that's fine. That's the next step is we are going to commence proceedings for the fiancé visa process in Australia, which is basically a lot of paperwork. As I said before, hopefully in 6 to 8 weeks we'll meet somewhere in between times. And it can take 6 months for the visa to be approved in Australia. Sometimes it can be 12 months. So I think it's fairly good, but that's our next step, and to start the process for Svetlana to come over. Obviously she said yes to the engagement. Her next step is to get all the paperwork. She'll come over, meet her parents, and then I'm sure that'll be fine, and then we'll get married in Australia.
Okay, and what about your parents? How do they react on the fact that you're going to Ukraine? You're a man, you're on the internet.
Well, I think that they were, I think like most parents, they're happy for their child if they're happy. That's the basic system. They were concerned initially, as I think I was, not with Svetlana, but in the process, because you know that the reputation the scammers that you do get in this situation, they were concerned for that purpose. But the only way that I could find out whether it was or not was to come visit. So they're very happy for me that I found somebody, and you know, Svetlana. I couldn't have landed on my feet, so I couldn't have done better, and I'm more than confident that Mum and Dad will love her as much as I do. And Renata's been an absolute blessing for Mum and Dad, so I'm quite convinced that there will be no issues with Svetlana, Renata, or Mum and Dad.
So your parents are already ready to...
Yeah, well, the last thing, because Dad's been, and Mum have been kept informed of our conversations and our chats, because Svetlana actually asked me to give a copy of the letters that she sent me to Mum and Dad to see what they think of the correspondence. And they were very, very happy. And the last thing Dad said before I got on the plane is, don't come back without it. So that's a pretty good indication of how he feels. Because at the end of the day, he wants me to be happy. So does Mum. So I think it'll all be a smooth sailing from here. A lot of paperwork, but apart from that, it'll all be just smooth sailing.
Okay, Kelly, thank you very much.
Pleasure, Sash.
It was really nice to meet you. And yes, you're welcome back to Ukraine to Svetlana in the near future. So. And I wish you good luck in your relationship.